Alright everybody, welcome back to part 2 of the Honda ECU chipping. If you didn't subscribe already, please do view video 1. I'm going to be doing it in short little sections because I know people like to work on one section at a time. Personally, I do. I see a lot of videos, they just jump around, so I'll zoom in on each section and do it so you can see what's going on and get the best magnification I can. We are working in the CN2 area, which will be the data logging port for the OBD1 Honda ECU, which is right here. So you have five slots, 1 through 5. Most kits, you're gonna be using 1 through 4. That's left to right. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can have a little set up like this and get that in focus for you guys. And it's a little fancy clip. You can have 4 pins sticking up. It doesn't matter. Right here is nothing special. You just want connection to that board. So we're going to clean this up. We're going to hit it with a little brake clean because there is a coating over this. So we got to take this coating off on both sides of the chipboard. I'm going to get that off and we're going to come back. Okay, we're on the back side of the board now. I'm gonna flip it back around so you can see. There's your 28 pin connector. There's your data port for your logging. And we're just gonna flip it around to the other side. That's your CN2 port. And it's right there. Bam. So we're going to go ahead and get that out now with some 3mm soldering wick and see if we can get that out. Cleaning off the soldering gun or soldering iron. Turn up the soldering iron a little bit. It's starting to come out. It's a delicate process. You don't want to rush it. To the next one. And you just gotta keep going through them. We're just wicking that solder right out. Okay. Trying to see where I can use some more of this. Probably hear my kids in the background blasting some Xbox, probably upstairs. two more. I'm just gonna end up desoldering all of them. And then I'll reflow the solder into them all. One again. For some reason this first one don't want to come out. I don't know why. Get into a brand new piece. Alright. Well, as you can see, pretty much desoldered the three holes. Yeah, it's just one, comport one for some reason. Let's see. Hopefully my battery don't die on my phone. Let's go right here. Try and get this out. It's tough doing this on camera. Come on. That's why you have a pick. So we can get in there and see if we can poke through the solder. Wow. Alright. Sorry I got that off camera. I'm just trying to get this first pin. It's acting silly. Okay. Well, sorry guys. This is actually getting recorded in real time, so just want to show you how hard it can actually be trying to get this stuff out. Let's switch hands. Alright, I was finally able to get the... Had some technical difficulties. Phone died. My wife wanted her screwdriver bit back. A whole bunch of crazy little things. But now we're oriented back to where you see the 28-pin connector, which is... Or 28-pin chip, which goes right there. And right down here is a data logger. Pins 1 through 4. CN2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pin 5 is left open. So it slid right in. You see, there's no real burnt. Nothing actually burnt on the board. The pin set stays in pretty well. So everything's flush. Let's get this thing set up here. All right. Use that same pick. Get a little bit of flux on them joints. A little bit of flux goes a long way. Soldering gun about half heat. Solder. Let me check that real quick. Pause the video. Let me check. Alright, so we're back and it was a success. Perfect. Soldered the first time. The board, everything is in perfect condition. No issues. Solder edge looks just like the factory. Wish I had better lighting. Let me see if I can get some better lighting in here. Hold on a second. Alright, if you look at that, that's where the data logger pins, port, whatever you want to call it, clip is put in. See, it's a nice clean install. We'll flip it around. There it is. CN2. It's in there tight. It's not going anywhere. And that's basically the hardest part of getting the data log connection port in. So, in the next video, we will work on chipping this section of the board, which is the EEPROM, or I don't know, wherever you write the memory to the ECU, how you want to do your fuel maps, your VTEC, all that cool stuff. We'll get that chip in. Well, that will actually, we're gonna put a socket board in here first, and then put a ZIF type switch to where we can release chips without damaging the board. We'll get that put in, and then we'll get this other chip put in right here. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.